This is Slough on the Great Western Main Line. Follow the markers over the footbridge to catch a train. Some doors are auto. Great Western Express offers the ability to ride and drive both express and commuter trains along the Great Western Main Line between London Paddington and Reading. You are currently riding an intercity 125 high-speed train formed of two Class 43 diesel locomotives hauling a selection of Mark III carriages. This train has a top speed of 125 miles per hour. Trainsim World allows you to ride and drive trains from a selection of internal and external camera angles. Let's take a look now by exploring the exterior of this train. Other internal and external camera views are available to be explored. These can be accessed from the number keys. You've only travelled a short distance here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to Great Western Express. You can marvel at the iconic London Paddington Terminus with its magnificent arched roof. Explore Old Oak Common Depot, where many trains are serviced. Deliver freight to Hayes and West Drayton processing plants, or haul containers in and out of London. Arrive into a fully modernised Reading station, or visit the nearby Reading Depot, where the Class 166 trains are maintained. Along the way, be sure to place route maps, safety signage, and locate the missing dispatch buttons. Choose from freight, passenger or high-speed trains, and start your journey today.
This is the Class 166 in Great Western Railway livery. This unit is used up and down the Great Western Main Line, providing stopping services to thousands of commuters each week. Today, you're going to learn how to take control of this unit, start it up, get it moving, and then bring it to a stop. Start by climbing aboard the unit. Enter through the cab door in front of you. Take a look around, and when you're ready, have a seat in the driver's chair. Set the reverser handle into the neutral. You need to charge the brakes before we start. When you're ready, hit the engine start button on the desk to get. Now, set the headlights to day. Put the train in forwards so we're ready to get moving. By setting the throttle brake to off, they will start to release. Nearly there. Now apply some power and get this unit moving. Ease the throttle brake handle into notch one. is bring this unit to a gradual stop. Set the throttle, brake handle. You're performing great and showing real confidence. All you need to do now is bring this unit to a gradual stop. Set the throttle, brake handle to braking one to apply a small amount of braking force and let the brakes do the rest. Now, if you remember everything I've shown you here, you will do just fine. This is the Class 43 high-speed train in Great Western Railway livery. Great work on being accepted as a driver for GWR. Today, you're going to learn how to take control of this iconic train, get it moving, and then bring it to a stop. Start by climbing aboard the locomotive. Enter through the cab door in front of you. Take a look around. Set the reverser handle into the neutral. This is the best part, hearing the engine revs build and starting to feel the power this powerful locomotive holds. When you're ready, things start to get a little more complicated from here, but we'll take it step by step. Set the headlights to day. Put the train in forward. Now apply some power and get this train moving. Ease the throttle handle into notch one. Now, to maintain our current speed, set the throttle handle back to idle. Train to a gradual stop. Set the train brake handle to initial. ready to head out there on your own now. If you remember everything I've shown you here, you will do just fine. This is a DBS Class 66 diesel locomotive, nicknamed Shed because of how it looks. This locomotive used to haul aggregates up and down the Great Western Main Line. Today, you're going to learn how to take control of this powerful freight locomotive. Start it up, get it moving, and then bring it to a stop. Start by climbing aboard the locomotive. Enter through the cab door in front of you. Take a look around. Now get the engine started. Set the engine run switch, generator field switch, and the control and fuel pump switch all to on. Here you go. Use the engine start button on the desk, then wait for the engine to get running and set the isolation switch to run. Braking system. Before we go anywhere, we need to run a quick brake test. First, hold the auto brake handle in the release position until the brake pipe control needle in front of you reaches 5. That means the brakes are completely released. The brakes now need charging, so a full application is needed. This time, hold the auto brake handle in the apply position until the brake pipe control needle is at 3. It looks as though the brakes are working as they should. All you need to do now is fully release the brakes again so we can get moving. Time to get moving. Turn the headlights and marker lights on. Put the train in forwards so we're ready to get moving. Now you need to release the last of the brakes, the parking brake. Nearly there. Now apply some power and get this train moving. Ease the throttle. I think this is fast enough for now. To maintain our current speed, set the throttle handle back to idle. Let's bring the train to a gradual stop. Using the auto brake handle in the apply position again, get the brake pipe control needle in front of you to around 4 to apply a gentle application, and then let the brakes do the rest.